Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.2, Problem 1. This is Problem 1 from Section 4.2. It says, for each one of the simplex tableaus shown below, circle the correct pivot element. And there are five tableaus or matrices written out, and we'll find the correct pivot element for each one. It just says circle it, so that's what we're going to do. So the first one is one of the smaller ones. It has three rows. The top row is 1, 4, 4, 1, 0, 0, 16. The second row is 2, 1, 5, 0, 1, 0, 20. And the bottom row is negative 3, negative 1, negative 2, 0, 0, 1, 0. So to find the correct pivot element, first what you want to do is find the correct pivot column by finding the most negative item in the bottom row. And as I look in the bottom row, I have three negative values, negative 3, negative 1, and negative 2. Now of those choices, negative 3 is what I describe as being the most negative. It occurs in the x1 column, the far left column. So the pivot element must be somewhere in the x1 column. And it's either the 1 in the top position or the 2 in the middle position. Your pivot can never be negative, and it can never be a 0. So to determine if our pivot is the 1 in the top position or the 2 in the middle position of the x1 column, we evaluate our ratios of the right-hand side value over the pivot column value. So in the top row, the right-hand side value is 16 over the pivot column value is 1. So 16 divided by 1 reduces to 16. And in the middle row, the right-hand side value is 20 over the pivot column value is 2. So 20 divided by 2 reduces to 10. So we want the smaller positive ratio, and 10 is certainly smaller than 16, and that ratio of 10 came from our middle row where we divided 20 from the right-hand side by 2 from the pivot column. So our pivot element for the first tableau is a 2. That's what we would have to pivot. So if we did have to pivot, again, we would turn that 2 into a 1 and then zero out the rest of the x1 column. And in a case like this, when you do pivot it, even though there's a 1 in the same column, in that x1 column where we have to pivot, you can't just swap rows like you can when you solve a matrix. When you start this to turn the 2 into a 1, you have to multiply the whole row by 1 over 2. So we don't have to pivot it. I just mentioned that as a reminder. Now the second tableau or matrix that we have to find the pivot for also has three rows. The top row is 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 18. The second row is 2, 2, 3, 0, 1, 0, 16. And the bottom row is negative 4, negative 6, negative 2, 0, 0, 1, and then 0. So again, to find the pivot, we want to first determine the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. So as I look in the bottom row, my negative values are negative 4, negative 6, and negative 2. Negative 6 is the most negative. It is in the x2 column. So the x2 column has to contain my pivot element. So in the x2 column, I have a 3 in the top position, a 2 in the middle position, negative 6 in the bottom, and the pivot can never be negative. So my pivot is either the 3 in the top or the 2 in the middle of that x2 column. So now, to determine which one it is, either the 3 or the 2, what we have to do, again, is find the ratio of right-hand side value over pivot column value and find the lowest one. So in the top row, the right-hand side value is 18 divided by the pivot column value is 3. So 18 divided by 3 gives me a result of 6. And then in the middle row, the right-hand side value is 16 divided by the pivot column value, which is 2. So 16 divided by 2 is 8. And now we want the smaller positive ratio. So 6 is certainly smaller than 8. So the ratio of 6 came from the top row where we divided our right-hand side value of 18 divided by the pivot column value of 3. So that means that our pivot for the second tableau, or second matrix, is the 3 that's in the top position of the x2 column. That would be the pivot. So again, to actually perform the pivot, you would turn that 3 into a 1 by multiplying 3 by 1 over 3, and then zero out the rest of the x2 column. But for this one, we just have to find the pivot column. Now, the next matrix is a little bit bigger. It has four rows. The top row is 1, 3, 1, 0, 0, 0 again, and 12. The second row is 2, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, and then 10. The third row is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 4. And the bottom row is negative 2, negative 1, 0, 0, 0 again, 1, and 0. So again, to find the pivot, you first must find the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. There are only two negative values in the bottom row, negative 2 and negative 1. The negative 2 occurs in the first column, the far left column, which is the x1 column. So the x1 column must be our pivot column. But now there are three values that the pivot could be. There's a 1 in the top position, a 2 in the second row, a 1 again in the third row, and then the negative 2 in the bottom row can never be the pivot. Your pivot can never be negative, it can never be 0. So now what we have to do is look at the ratios of right-hand side value over pivot column value and find the lowest positive ratio. So in the top row, the right-hand side value is 12, divided by the pivot column value, which is 1. So 12 divided by 1 equals 12. So that's the ratio for the top row, 12. So the second row, same ratio, right-hand side value is 10, divided by pivot column value is 2. So 10 divided by 2 is 5. So that's the other ratio. And now, in the last row, or the third row down, the last row that we could have a pivot from, the right-hand side value is 4 divided by the pivot column value, which is 1. 4 divided by 1 is 4. Now, we want the lowest ratio that we came up with. So the top row gave us a ratio of 12, the second row gave us a ratio of 5, and the third row gave us a ratio of 4. 4 is the smallest of those ratios. It came from the third row where we divided a right-hand side value of 4 divided by a pivot column value of 1. So the pivot element in my third tableau is the 1 in the x1 column that's in the third row. And again, to finish the pivot, if you had to do that, ordinarily you have to do some work to turn the pivot element into a 1. This one already is a 1. And then you would have to zero out the rest of the column. And just to remind you, if there is a tie for the most negative value in the bottom row, you can choose either one. And if there's a tie for the smallest positive ratio in any particular row, you can choose either one. When there's a tie, you get to choose either one. But in this case, there was clearly a most negative value in the bottom row. There was clearly a smallest positive ratio. So on to the next tableau. It's another larger tableau. It has four rows. The top row in this tableau is 2, 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 0 again, and then 25. The second row is 4, 3, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0, 40. The third row is 3, 1, 6, 0, 0, 1, 0, 60. And finally, the fourth row, or bottom row, is negative 4, negative 2, negative 3, 0, 0, 0 again, 1, and then finally 0. So again, we want to find the pivot element, we want to circle it. For us, we have to find the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. As I look in the bottom row, my negative values are negative 4, negative 2, and negative 3. Negative 4 is the most negative value in the bottom row. The negative 4 occurs in the x1 column, so the pivot must also be in the x1 column. That's my pivot column, the x1 column. Now, which one is actually the pivot? You have a 2 in the top position of the x1 column, a 4 in the second position down the x1 column, and a 3 in the third position down the x1 column. And of course, at the bottom, the very bottom of the x1 column, you have a negative 4. Your pivot can never be negative, and it can never be 0. So to determine which one of the values in the x1 column is actually the pivot, we divide our ratios. Right-hand side value over pivot column value. So in the top row, our right-hand side value is 25 divided by a pivot column value, which is 2. So 25 over 2 is 12.5, or 12.5, however you want to write it. In the second row, the right-hand side value is 40 divided by the pivot column value, which is 4. 40 divided by 4 is 10. And then in the third row, the right-hand side value of the pivot column value, the right-hand side value is 60. And you will divide that by the pivot column value, which is 3. 60 divided by 3 is 20. Now, the different possible ratios of right-hand side over pivot column are 12.5, 10, or 20. Well, 10 is the smallest ratio of the ones that I have to choose from. The 10 occurred in the second row of my matrix. So I go back to the x1 column, which I know is my pivot column. And in the second row of that x1 column, I have a 4. So that 4 in the second position down of my x1 column is the pivot element. So again, if we act to actually complete the pivot, we would need to turn that 4 into a 1 by multiplying the whole row by 1 over 4, and then zero out the rest of the pivot column or the x1 column. And finally, there's one remaining tableau that we have to find the pivot element for. It also has 4 rows. The top row is 2, 2 again, 8, 1, 0, 0, 0 again, and then 40. The second row is 4, negative 5, 6, 0, 1, 0, 0, 60. The third row is positive 2, then negative 2, then 6, 0, 0, 1, 0, and then 24. And the bottom row is negative 14, negative 10, negative 12, 0, 0, 0 again, 1, and finally 0. So now to find the correct pivot element and circle it, first we need to find the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. So as I look in the bottom row, my negative values are negative 14, negative 10, and negative 12. Negative 14 is the most negative, so again my pivot is occurring in the x1 column. So some value in the x1 column must be the pivot element. And my choices are negative 2 in the top position, 4 in the second position down, a 2 in the third position down. The value in the bottom position, which is negative 14, again, cannot be the pivot. Your pivot can never be negative and it can never be 0. So to determine which one of the values in my x1 column is the pivot element, we will evaluate the ratios of right-hand side value over pivot column value. In the top row, that ratio of right-hand side value of a pivot column value is 40 divided by 2, which divides out to 20. In the second row, that ratio of right-hand side value of a pivot column value is 60 divided by 4, which divides to 15. And in the third row, the ratio of right-hand side value over pivot column value is 24 divided by 2. So 24 divided by 2 is 12. So now the possible ratios I have to choose from are 20, 15, and 12. And I want the smallest, so 12 is smaller than 20 or 15. So the ratio of 12 occurred in the third row of this matrix. So I go back to the column that has to be my pivot column, which is the x1 column. The value in the third row down is a 2. So the 2 that's in the third row of the x1 column must be the pivot element. So I've circled that one. And again, if we had to complete the pivot, we would first turn that 2 into a 1 by multiplying the entire row by 1 over 2, and then we would zero out the rest of the x1 column. But all we have to do for this is find the pivot and circle it, and we did.